scientists were worried that the gadget would not work. If it did fail to detonate, the plutonium at the core of the bomb was far too precious to lose. As Manhattan Project physicist Benjamin Bederson and procurement officer Harry Allen explain, that concern led to the creation of Jumbo.
My assignment was to study the ability of Jumbo to contain an abortive atomic bomb. If the atomic bomb did not actually work properly, the radioactive material would have spilled all over the landscape. There would have been a disaster of enormous proportions. So the idea was to put the bomb inside this container. If it fizzled, then the container would hold it and keep it from spreading around and then destroying Los Alamos, essentially. If it worked, then it didn't matter because it would vaporize the container. So that was what was called Jumbo.
What they didn't want to do was lose the very valuable and scarce fissionable material by just having it blown around in case there was no fission. You see, they wanted to save the fissionable material in this container so they could recover it and reuse it again. Of course, as it turned out, they got more and more confidence in what they were doing and decided it would do more harm than good to set it off in there because if they'd lose a lot of measurements and so forth.